Whenever you're ready, Kevy.
Welcome, Beach Bums and Surf Chicks. Here we are. We're at the round 5 of the Aquadiva Surf Iron Lady Qualifying Series. We're at Manly Beach in sunny Sydney. Sunny Sydney, Trent?
What an intro, Kevin. It's not the sunniest I've ever seen Manly, but...
Sorry, mate, did I trip you up?
But it'll do. We've got a Casey Leo, a couple of the Moolabar girls, Chloe Jones and Maddie Dunn, who won last round.
And
on
they're
the
off,
line.
Mate. They're off. Let's go. Let's get into it. None of this... Oh, sorry. I said something I shouldn't have there.
There we go. There's a little bank here. It's a tricky little trough that they've had to negotiate. And a bit of a wave going on. It's probably only 3 foot, but it's breaking pretty heavy and it could cause a few upsets.
Certainly could. Shades of the 2000 World Lifesaving Champs I saw here at Manly Beach. And, that was 12 years ago, wasn't it? So we'll stop talking about it.
So there's a few new competitors in the field. They signed up, but they haven't managed to get to a round yet until now. So Devin Halligan, Tatum Lawler's a New South Wales girl that's made it to Torquay. Danielle Radford made it to the last round, so it's really becoming a national event now.
Certainly is, mate. It's really good to see all these different girls from around the country getting involved. It's an astounding amount of colours popping over waves out there, all the Aquadiva togs floating around.
There's plenty of Aquadiva going on out there, which is great to see. That looks like
it looks
Steph
like
Cronin in front.
Is it?
She's in front. She's from Metro Leandra, and she's had a couple of good results. She'll be wanting her first maiden win, won't she?
I imagine she would, mate. That's not a bad call.
Jordan White in from Warilla Barrack, pushing for the lead. And on the left is Hannah Minogue. So all strong board paddlers showing their class early.
Yeah, it's obviously you want to if your board's your first, your strongest leg, you want it to come first and really get out in front and try and own the race from the start.
And young Devin Halligan that we just mentioned earlier from Manly Beach has also pulled down that front wave, and she might end up closest to the pin.
Yeah, she'll be doing well there. They'll have to watch out for that trough we talked about at the start. There we go, just skimming across that. That's clever. It's
a few different ideas. A couple of ditching the board and a couple... Oh, Hannah's ditched.
Yeah. I don't think that really paid off. She probably lost a bit of ground there. So,
solid transition from the Manly and Warilla Barrack girls.
Yeah, just running past Harriet Brown there.
Just smashing again. The Queensland girls in the transition there.
Yeah.
But good on them. This is their home beach. Home beach, Devin Halligan, and she's showing us why she's a local.
Yep, Hannah Minogue up there. Joanna Baxter just coming in with the top five there too.
It's a long wade.
Just a long wade, mate. Once they got over that little ditch, the bank is actually a bit longer than it seems after the board, so they're able to get the taller girls be getting the long legs up and really striding out there.
Looked like young Maddie Dunn going face first into the little trough there, so yep. She's still in the mix, but Devin Halligan has managed to get herself a handy little nifty lead.
A nifty lead? Is that right, mate? As opposed to a flat lead?
I don't know what the opposite of nifty is, mate. Thanks for putting me on the spot while we're mid-sentence.
No, that's all right, mate. Can you get a dictionary?
There's a guy going right in front of the camera there.
All right.
Just cutting off the leaders. No, I think he stayed out of the way as they're heading out to the swim can. But it looks like Devin Halligan hasn't given him an inch. She's going to hit that red and yellow. Well, then it's still a solid lead.
Yeah, it's decent. Let's see how far along she gets before they turn the first one. There's definitely at least one, two cans lead there.
Some solid camera work going on. Steph Cronin leading the chase bunch with, that could be another Moolabar competitor in second.
Yeah, you can just see there's a few elbows flying in there. I don't think these girls are giving any. There's probably a heel in the face and a bit of an elbow up the chops and
in the guts.
Thanks very much. Yeah, help yourself to. Oh, there we go. There's a ski race going on as well.
No friends at the cans.
Should we commentate on that?
If you like, mate.
Okay, that guy on the watch. Nah, I'm not going to.
Nah, come on. Let's stick with the Aquadiva series. As exciting, it's getting totting up here as Devin Halligan is still in front, but
she
the girls
really wants to get a wave in front here. And just basically put the race beyond doubt. Actually, I can't see her. Where's she going?
A few waves on the horizon. I think Devin's just on the left of screen out of picture. But
who's pulled that? It's a cracking wave.
It's a Moolabar cap.
Is that Hannah Minogue?
It's not Hannah Minogue. It could be Maddie Dunn or Chloe Jones. But right. They've got a good wave right up onto... There's Steph Cronin on the left. And just in the far end of screen is Devin
Right, right. So she came well inside the course there.
I think Devon's had to work all the way to the beach. Yeah. She's just got a little wave and caught back, grab gap, pulled that gap back a little.
Nice, nice. Commentary gold. Yeah, she's actually managed to just stay in front. The girl's really tried to jag a wave on her there, and she's done well to keep her little lead.
We didn't do our vocal warm-ups today.
No, we didn't. The quick brown fox jumped over Devon Halligan.
Devon's off. She's got a good rating there. She's really going to attack that back. But Steph's right on her heels now.
Yeah, yeah. They'll have to, as I said before, put in some big strokes to get up right on her wash to really make a meal of this race. But it looks like Devon's going to get away.
Devon's an under-19 competitor. Maddie Dunn's an under-17 competitor, and she won her first round last week. And she's right on the heels. There's a wave.
There we go. That'll sort.
Boom.
Sort the ladies from the girls. Well,
I think she stayed on there. That was pretty solid work by Devon.
Yeah, that's it. How's the camera? Camera boat going? Camera boat struggling.
Camera work. Right. Which maybe we should have put the camera on Devon or Steph. They stayed on better than the camera guy.
That's a good idea. Let's do that next time.
So Devon's out in front. She's going to make her way to the cans while the other girls are copping a few. But Steph's also out.
Good on her.
Hang on a sec. Devon's going the wrong can, ladies and gentlemen.
What? Hang on.
Steph Cronin's in second place.
She's seen it. Devon's seen it now. She's turning. That's a hell of a mistake. So Steph is chopped into first.
She has lost a massive amount of ground. She's lucky to still be in second. That's really unfortunate for Devon. It is a bit tricky because the apex is directly behind the red and yellow, so it is a little deceiving.
That is true, but you know, as every competitor knows, to finish the race first, you must finish. So you have to go around all the cans.
Oh yeah, right.
And you know, if you don't know where they are, then it's going to be very hard to finish it first.
No, I hear you, but all credit to Steph Cronin. She was in the lead in the board, and has worked hard the whole way, stayed in touch, and just took her opportunity to get that.
She's just waiting for a wave here that could drop, land her right in the drop zone. That could be a bad choice.
Oh, she's chosen this one.
As long as she holds it. That's actually quite a late drop. She'll have to get the power on.
It's all over for you too, love.
Yeah, no, she's held it well. She's held it well.
And that's Devon in second. She's held.
There's a bigger wave at the back for the girls in third and fourth. And it looks like one's gone. And two will hold it.
Could have been Maddie gone there. She was going okay in third. Devon's going to have a good crack here. She's up and running.
Yeah, fourth and fifth.
Steph stayed on.
They're kissing. It's kissing skis, not.
Steph's winning. I think she's got it. No worries. Oh, there's a little bit of a late takeoff.
Yeah, well
late
done.
Chicken out, hey.
Well done to Steph Cronin there. She's had a fantastic race. Devon Halligan a little bit unlucky, but you have to pick your right line. Hannah Minogan third. That's good points for her. Some girl from Willa Barrack, mate. We've got
That's Geordie White. Anne Glenn in the, rounding out the top five. But I'm impressed with the ladies today. That was a pretty heavy break at the back, and they've all negotiated quite well. A couple of spills.
Yeah, yeah, as definitely showing some skills from the New South Wales girls who really stepped up to it.
Oh, Danielle Radford's just taking Casey on the line there for grab a couple extra points.
Yeah, Casey's whipped the cap off there. I don't think she's very happy.
A little disappointed. She's got a couple of good results early, so she wants to maximise her lead, which she currently has, but maybe not anymore.
Don't want to get on her side, bad side, when she's gone BA.
Really?
No.
So there we go. That's the Aquadiva.
Oh, we're going to the same hotel here?
Hopefully, we'll see what happens. That's the series wrap up for round five. See you at our Freshwater Beach for the next round. Thanks for coming.
Can't wait.